Valley TV welcomes you to Yorkville's Campbell Stadium, where tonight the Yorkville Foxes will be facing off against the Hubs of Rochelle. I'm Tom Molding, and alongside me tonight is Evan Wiseman. Evan, are you ready for a great game of football tonight?
I am. This is one of the first games that I will be able to see out of Yorkville, so I am super excited. I've been watching them on paper all year. That doesn't really do it. Now that we're out, we're watching the field. Both teams set off great starts to their season.
Absolutely.
I'm just nothing but excited.
It's going to be a great night. Yorkville, as we've seen last season, they have a great energy. The team just seems to feed off of their crowd. It's great. And tonight, both teams, in this third week of football, Yorkville is going in 1-1, coming off a loss their first week from West Aurora High School. They lost that game 33-3. And last week, at Yorkville's first home game, they managed to defeat Marion Catholic Spartans 54-7. So it's going to be great to see what they have to offer up tonight, Evan.
That first game that you mentioned against Yorkville, West Aurora, being from the Upstate 8 Conference, is that conference has to be one of the most dominating in high school football, especially in Illinois, with teams like Batavia, who were on the state playoffs a while back. Geneva had a powerful, although I'm a little biased. Both St. Charles opportunities there. I mean, you see the games that West Aurora takes on in their conference. I mean, the fact that Yorkville was able to stay so in step with them until, some at the very end.
For sure.
It just goes to show what this Yorkville team can do.
Yorkville as a team, they're fighting tooth and nail for every inch when they have possession. They will go as far as they can with as much heart as they can. Coach Dan McGuire is phenomenal. Head coach of Yorkville is doing a great job of telling his boys what needs to get done on the field for offense and defensive reasons.
Well, it's not exactly his first season. He's been with this team for a little bit now, and it really shows. It really shows.
It shows.
On the field.
He cares about his team. His team want to impress him. They want him to make him proud. On the other side of the spectrum, Yorkville, Rochelle, I should say, they're coming into this game 1-1-2. They defeated Corliss High School with a big win, 53-0 in their first week. Their second game, their first home game of the season, they lost to Johnsburg High School 46-21, and they're under the head coach, Kevin Crandall's head coach at Rochelle. So let's see what he has to offer up. He has 23 years of experience.
Well, I mean, you saw that play out in both games where the teams were able to stay, team very professional, even though, they did take both a tough loss, and they also, provided a little bit of a blowout for in that first game. Shows the coaching staff was very professional. I know that the players themselves were, they as a team are well put together, as a program well put together.
Yep.
And that normally can translate to some pretty successful football.
We see Rochelle as a well-uniformed team, very small, very close-knit. Number 21 putting that ball up in the air, that's Eddie Villobis. Not quite caught up by, I didn't quite see who had that, but managed to cover it.
Small fumble. It's number one, Zach Hurst. Didn't quite see a available slot to kind of sneak through, and I think there's a little bit of a panic moment where he tried to figure out where he was going before he even had the ball.
He wanted to make sure that even when he had that ball bounced out of his hands, fumbling it a little bit, he wanted to cover it, which of course was a smart move. Ball spotted on Yorkville's own 24-yard line, so they got about three quarters of the whole field to go. I do believe I see number 21 out there as quarterback.
Flags down. Looks like number 68 jumped. That of Rochelle would have been Kyle. I'm thinking Kyle Esther, but I'm not sure.
It's going to be a 5-yard whoop. 5-yard penalty on Rochelle there, making Yorkville first and 5 early on in this game.
Pretty good start when you can catch the defense off. You can tell that maybe Rochelle might be a little bit nervous stepping into this game.
There might be a little on edge. They don't know what they're coming into. Yorkville's a new team this season, first time facing them.
Although that wrap-up was pretty good. Defense closing down the hole very quickly. Only about a gain of 3 yards, 2 or 3 yards for C.J. Bell.
C.J. Bell is definitely a name we're going to have to keep a lookout for on the Yorkville side of the spectrum. Last game in throughout even last season, he's been a great running back. He can run the ball. He'll find the weak links in any defense, and he'll run right through them. It's fantastic to see him play.
as he'll drive again, try to go up the middle. He's still on his feet.
Nice breakaway there.
Just a gang of purple trying to take him down.
CJ Bell again, the carry.
So tackle credited to number 45 of the Hubs, and that'll be Riley Williams. Yorkville, though, still picking up enough yards to get the first down, about a carry of six or seven when they only needed three. And lining up in the shotgun.
Here you see Ty Laramidas. When he looks like this, he's normally going to pass it. Hands it off, though, to C.J. Bell. C.J. Bell making it for the final hop. Going over what I believe is the 40-yard line, just barely.
Number 23, C.J. Bell, running the carry.
So that will be a pretty impressive carry, bringing it halfway. C.J. Bell continues to average out at about 5 yards a carry.
It's really impressive to see a team going about halfway, even off their first down. Always good when they get that extra gain. We see a long pass, not good, incomplete. That was meant for that was meant for Jason Lewan. He was had his back turned to that ball.
Didn't quite get the speed behind the ball that he needed to. I guess he felt a little pressure. That Rochelle defense was coming in fast.
Yorkville might not have much to worry about right now. They're on the third down. They got 5 yards to go. Make it far enough. They can't get that first down. You might see Yorkville try to run it across in a final ditch effort on their fourth down, but you don't want to risk it.
Well, I guess they're going to the air. Pass looked good, but will be incomplete. Flags down. Ooh, Yorkville jumping early, attempting to get that edge.
Not wanting to get caught with a false start there. That 5 yard penalty will really hurt them unless they can get a good run off this down here. We see them third and 10, ball on the 37 yard line in Yorkville territory.
Guessing they're going to the air again on that right side. They've got some height over on that. Jason Lewan, 6'6", steps in. He's got a body. He can box out defensive backs. He's one to watch.
If you can get a tall wide receiver and he can catch the ball, run it well, you can sure bet that's going to be their main goal tonight.
And in the backfield.
Going a little off.
Completely just leveled on that play. And there seems to be a player getting up a little slowly.
Yeah. Rochelle, though, showing off a bit of edge. Showing that they can rush Yorkville. They can pressure them. And they're not paying attention. They'll put them backfield for a loss of yardage. They only lost about 3 yards there, thankfully. But we're on the fourth down for Yorkville now.
So no injury recorded, but it was a little bit of an equipment malfunction. In fact, one of the Rochelle players, if I'm correct, got hooked onto, was that 21 for Ty? So no injury, but it will look like the Yorkville coming out to punt.
Back deep in the field, I do believe that is Cade Henry putting it up, but there's a flag on the play.
So did not catch to see what the foul was, but it seemed like maybe both teams did jump a tad early. I'm not quite sure who they're calling it on. So it's a legal formation.
Rochelle decides to accept or decline.
So Yorkville will be charged with the illegal formation. Rochelle will decline the penalty and take the so they'll take the punt where it landed. I guess they thought that Yorkville, having some small, strong special teams, probably if they were given a second chance, would send it a little farther.
I can imagine that. Well, we're gonna see what Rochelle can do as they go on their first possession.
Quick run up the middle, opportunity.
That was Noah Mershon, if I'm not mistaken, running that up, only gaining a gain of a couple yards there, only 2 yards, second and eight on their own 42-yard line, pardon me. Austin Avery getting credited with that tackle for the Foxes. All right, ball going back in play. Number five again, Noah Mershon holding onto that ball with a great receive, but fumbled the ball. We see Yorkville. That was number eight, Justin Williams, picking that up. That was Matt Albers from Rochelle losing a grip on that ball.
That was, got very lucky being that ruled incomplete since he went down with that. You know, that you could argue that that might have been a fumble. So
right now it seems like Yorkville's just going to live and let live. Let them let Rochelle live out their third down right now, third and eight. Noah Mershon, keep an eye out on him. He's trying to play the passing game tonight, and it's been working out well, or at least with that last pass. It was something great, but got lucky it was ruled incomplete. Mershon again with a long pass. That was caught by Steven Yeichner.
Impressive. Just tiptoeing on that line. Tackle credit to Justin Williams.
Eichner definitely playing chicken with the train right there. Running to his last, running to just about outside of the out of bound line. Caught that ball, ran it out before being tackled down.
Credit where credit is due though. Noah Mershon, fantastic pass.
Wonderful pass, ball handed off to number 25, Matt Albers. He's running, doing a good job of it, making about a 30-yard run for a touchdown for Rochelle.
Steps up quickly, we saw that come around the left side. Just had daylight off of two great blocks, what a run.
From a last-ditch effort, a great pass by Noah Mershon to a great run by Matt Albers for a touchdown. That was a great series of plays there for Rochelle Hubs.
Well, we actually saw them kind of catch Yorkville a little off the side. We do have an injury on the play, so there will be a stop for just a sec. But the just the opportunity that they had around that outside that Yorkville caught a little bit sleeping. Couldn't find space to move a defender over there.
Absolutely. After a series of plays like that, you got to hope Yorkville's awake and ready to see what, or ready to read now what Rochelle's putting out. We got a taste of Rochelle. I mean, Yorkville didn't really have a time, or much time, I should say, on the offense.
Well, when you've only got two blockers to pick up two defenders, I mean, things like that happen. Teams can work magic with that opportunity that you give them, and we saw that with Rochelle. So it looks like they're going to keep their, if my eyes don't deceive me, looks like they might be going for two.
I think you're correct. I think Rochelle's going to try to go for an even larger lead than they already have, go for the two-point conversion.
Well, when you see at the high school level, it might just be the fact that they don't really focus on special teams all that much.
Well, we see Mershon with another pass. It was incomplete.
Well, I can already tell you the key to this game. Considering he's only thrown, Mershon's only thrown two bad passes all game. Both of them, he was very pressured. You can tell that if you let him get comfortable in that pocket, he is going to let it fly, and he's got wide receivers who can go and get that ball.
And you know, Noah Mershon has been throwing great passes of the number we've seen already. Wide receivers are really readily to be trusted in. And the defense, you can sure bet that they are going to be guarding Noah Mershon as best they can when Yorkville defense is, you know, knocking out their door.
But no matter how good the defense is, I mean, Eichner with the catch on the line.
That was
for Rochelle.
Definitely something he'll be talking about for a long time.
Crazy stuff.
We're going to expect to see a lot more from Eichner later on tonight. After a play like that, you can sure bet that the coach is going to want him out there longer.
So back for the Foxes, Wazowski and Bell.
And putting it up for the Hubs, we see Eddie Villalobos. We hear a lot of noise coming from the Yorkville pep band on the Yorkville side of the field. Villalobos puts a rather moderate kick up, but that ball fumbled right out of the hands of it. Could not quite see it, but we had the officials coming out into the field.
And the same thing that happened on the opening kickoff seems to work again for Rochelle. That ball getting way up with some great hang time. And just tough to control. So once again, Yorkville kind of a bobble on the kickoff.
Earlier this season, Yorkville's been readily expecting that ball to go deep, but Rochelle's definitely catching him off guard with these shallow kicks. We both see Bell, one of the receivers back there, when that kick was sent down. Bell was ready to catch that deep kick, but didn't quite come to him. It caught midfield for him.
Well, once again, the picking up about 4 yards every carry for C.J. Bell. It's regardless of what happens, you know, he's pretty sure to get that few extra yards you need.
C.J. Bell is going to be a never-say-die athlete as we see him right now.
Now, that was an impressive fake, but unfortunately not enough. Will bounce out of the hands of, I believe that was Austin Avery, the intended receiver.
Yep, bounced right off his, square off his chest, and pass will be ruled incomplete. So Fox is going to be starting back from 3rd and 6 on their own 38-yard line, trying to find a better way to deal with getting around Rochelle defense, which has pretty much had an answer for everything Yorkville's been doing on the offense.
Austin Avery set once again in that Yorkville favored shotgun. Let's see where we're going. It seems to be a quick pass and
barely fighting across the line of scrimmage there. Laramidas made a pass over to Jason Lawan. It was not quite enough. It was only a gain of a yard or two, if any.
He's a player that can get low and truck despite his height. So when you pair him up with only one defensive back and he's got that running room, you know, normally you can see him kind of run over guys, but not in this case.
Rochelle is reading Ty Laramidas from Yorkville, and they're expecting him to pass it. Back deep for the Hubs to receive it. I do believe that is... Could not quite get a read on him, but we're going to see Yorkville trying to pick that up. Not going to happen.
Punt will roll out of bounds at about the 27-yard line.
That was a very York. That was a lucky roll there for the Foxes, letting that ball roll a little bit more.
So now, hopefully, we can find the Yorkville Foxes, you know, setting up and getting this done with a stop. Rochelle, just massive powerhouse on that first few plays.
Very impressive plays we've seen from Noah Mershon.
And he is very free to just pick up what I believe was about 15, 16 yards on that carry.
I agree with you. That was about 15 yards. And if you let a free man run, he'll keep on going. Brandon Reifstek credited with that stop there.
Rochelle once again coming to the huddle. It's going to be, I'm guessing, after that success, they've got to keep it on the ground.
If it's working for you, both on the ground and in the air, you got to find a happy medium in between running and passing.
Rochelle trying to go with the carry, so he'll step out. I'm sorry, that's Alex Harvey on that carry. And what looked to be a hold on that left side, I believe, from Rochelle, but I'm not sure.
I do believe you're correct.
So it will be a personal foul for that chop block on Rochelle. So that'll move back, if I'm correct, about 10 yards.
I do believe you're correct. Definitely... good news for Yorkville, trying to find a read on your Rochelle's offense.
Now, 15 yards.
Wow. Way back deep. Now, Rochelle definitely has been playing a great game, and it's only their second possession. A great game in the air, a great game on the ground. if they can find a happy medium, they'll really start to confuse Yorkville. Coach Dan McGuire will try to have to find a way to strategize around Rochelle's offense, I should say. Pardon me.
Well, it's something that Yorkville can do is adjust. So we'll see, you know, kind of in the middle of the game, I think that we might be able to hit the restart button and see almost two completely different teams once they come out of the locker rooms.
Absolutely. Yorkville's a team known for adapting, and from what we're seeing now, Rochelle's just a team of pure power. If you get them maybe out of their stern rut, you might be able to confuse Rochelle.
Well, right there, they didn't have a stop around that right side. You saw the defense shift over, and next thing you know, you got yourself a stop. Even if they only gained, you know, one or two yards.
Yeah, and
they've got a lot of ground to cover.
Every yard is worth it, especially when you're 2 and 26. 26 yards to go till their next first down. You can see on your screen that is a wide margin. So we're going to see Mershon with a long throw. Too far. That was meant for Matt Albers. Could not quite grab that ball. Too far out of reach for Albers. Mershon definitely needs to take back a little mustard from that shot.
Well, once again, you saw him a little bit rushed. So Yorkville's kind of keying in on where they need to be to stop Mershon.
That's the first step to stopping an offensive pass, an offensive rush, is reading what the quarterback is going to do and where the carrier is going to go. Here we go. You can definitely wonder what's going through Noah Mershon's head right now.
He's only got one back.
Here he goes. Looks like he gets sacked right there. Credited with that tackle is just a number of people. I see that's Ryan Venable out there along with, I do believe, Mario Cal.
Credit for about a half tackle each. That's just imploded for Rochelle.
Absolutely. Actually credited. I'm going to give credit where credit was due. That was not Ryan Venable. That was Austin Avery. The Hubs just getting edged out. They're going into punt formation. Yorkville ready. Ball's going up way deep. Strong too points. Short. We see Zach Herbst really hoping that was going a little bit further. That ball spotted out at the 40-yard line.
So Yorkville with an opportunity to get on the board here as they've slowly kind of figured it out on defense. Let's see if they've got a game plan for this drive.
They definitely got to make all of their moves. Tyron Laramidas, quarterback, has definitely got to be on his toes tonight. Doesn't have as much time as we've seen him in past games. Rochelle is a fast team, man. They will get behind you if you let them.
CJ Bell trucking through. Has already broke two tackles in that scrum. He'll pick up about 4 yards. About six.
CJ Bell is definitely one of their stronger running backs on Yorkville's side.
Well, as long as you can, if you're going to go through the middle, as long as you're getting 4 yards of carry, you know, you're going to get success.
If it works, it works. And CJ Bell proven that he can just truck on through and break as many tackles as he can, breaking across for a first down for Yorkville.
So a gain of about five as well. So CJ Bell once again continuing his about 5 yard a carry average.
Always great to see somebody who has that utmost confidence going in just to the heart of Rochelle's defense. Well, ball spotted on the 49-yard line. Yorkville has half a field to go for their first touchdown of the night. 3 minutes and 36 seconds remain here in the first quarter.
Once again to Bell. And don't get taken out the legs. 22. Didn't quite get the block that he was used to around that side, so CJ Bell is going to go onto the sidelines to take a quick breather.
When you're being played like that, it's definitely respectable to take a breather. Nothing will be said wrong about you. That tackle there was made by number 42 from the Hubs, Elren Metzger, bringing down Bell there.
Well, here's the problem with, I think Yorkville is, you know, it's really early in the game to call a pattern, but it seems like they tend to go pass as soon as Bell steps off the field.
They got to find their way to adapt as we see Laramidas in a shotgun formation looking to pass it. Then for Lawan, can Lawan get it in time? He cannot get it, falls down, falls just short of that ball. Putting out the pressure there on from the Hubs was Steven Eichner.
Rochelle not as in tune with that play as they probably wish they were, though.
Not
at all,
actually.
Got lucky with the overthrow.
Now, with C.J. Bell being off the field, we can see one of the great things Yorkville can do. It's adapt. And Yorkville can adapt beautifully. We saw just what would have been almost a great pass to Lawan, just a little short of that. But we're going to see Laramidas go in the shotgun formation again, and we're probably going to be looking at another passing attempt here.
Open on that right side with two wide receivers.
Laramidas deciding he's going to run it himself, passes it with a very quick pass. Very great tackle there by Eichner.
Strong hit. Ball goes out, so that's incomplete. The intended receiver was intended for Brady Fisher. But he just could not hold on.
Eichner found exactly who Ty Laramidas was going for, and he brought him down hard. Very great on Eichner's part.
So once again, Yorkville have to resort to a punt. These teams seem to kind of, you know, evened out a little bit here.
Absolutely.
What a great punt.
Rochelle may be in the lead, but Yorkville's definitely getting their read on Rochelle.
So if Yorkville can just continue what they do best, and that's stop that pass game, Rochelle might find themselves, you know, a little bit deep in their own end zone.
They'll find themselves in a sticky situation, and they might not have much time to get out of it if Yorkville picks up their game. And as we see them now, they've been definitely picking up their game. Early on, with about 2 minutes, 25 seconds left, Yorkville has changed their play style many times. C.J. Bell, their main running back, took a seat for a little bit, and we just saw quarterback Ty Laramidas not afraid to throw that ball to Jason Lawan.
Run play. He's got space and first down. Great carry from Rochelle's line. Has just been able to open up holes all over that place. Running backs have been pushing through pretty strong.
Running backs on both spectrums. Just both impressive athletes tonight.
Under the gun, small pitch.
Pitch number 12, that was Noah Knight with that on the carry.
Number 4, Sean Coon, and number 56 was Eric Jackson on the stop for the boxes.
So Metzger around that right side can find space, although I've noticed that Rochelle likes to cut in as opposed to kind of go on that, try to use the speed on the outside, try to go to the sideline. They find themselves cutting inside, so I'm guessing that they think that they can body up Yorkville a little bit better, make contact and try to get those extra yards.
There you go, we see.
Once again, motion the fake. Worked on me, but did not work for Yorkville.
Yorkville definitely on their toes. Not going to put up with any fake passes, pardon me, that Rochelle puts out. Now, Rochelle, personally, I don't think they can keep doing fake passes. If it works, you can do it maybe once, and Yorkville will catch on. They'll understand that Rochelle's a tricky team. They'll go for the fake, but Yorkville quickly reading that and bringing down the actual carrier there.
Well, when you go into the play action, you know, it's kind of hit or miss. So far, Rochelle with 6 points on the board has hit once. Let's see if they can do it again.
Yep, 35 seconds left on the clock in quarter number one. We saw number 57 there. Deshaun Ishmael kind of got carried away.
Rochelle will get the first down.
31, Austin Avery on the assist.
So far, we've seen Rochelle definitely keep it on the ground as opposed to the pass game that we saw kind of work for them a little earlier. Do you think that maybe they're getting a little nervous because they like to hang out in the pocket there?
I think since they like to hang out in the pocket there, they're definitely getting a little nervous. But since they're on their first down, they don't have much to lose. We're not going to see him pass until maybe around their third down, or maybe if they're really feeling desperate, their fourth down attempt too. 3 seconds ticking down on the clock here. Refs just going to let it keep on running. And that's the end of the first quarter. Early on, Rochelle has an early lead over Yorkville, 6-0. We're going to see what happens here in the second quarter after this commercial break. Stay here on Fox Valley TV.
Mom, can we get some ice cream?
Please, Mom, please.
No, we're having dinner soon.
Please.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you just as you are.
Now, come on, Mom, come on. All right.
I know, 2 seconds. Hang on, just stand still. Stand still,
love. This is insane.
1 second. I know.
Just
go.
No. Boys, hang on, boys.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you just as you are.
Welcome back to Fox Valley TV, and if you're just joining us, it's the second quarter of a very strategic game between the Yorkville Fighting Foxes and the Rochelle Hubs.
Right now, only 6-2-0, Rochelle leading. The away team drove about an hour to get here, and they definitely were playing game plans in the bus ride, because so far they've been pretty amazing.
Rochelle, really wanted to take that early lead, proving that they can at least get dominance over Yorkville early on in the game. They got that first touchdown, I do believe, 4 minutes in. And they've not let go of that lead. They've been putting an end to Yorkville's possessions and offensive rushes. And Yorkville's actually been getting a read on them in the later parts of the first quarter.
Credit where it's due. Yorkville definitely coming back and putting down a lot of the momentum swings that Rochelle has had. But that play action has been getting to him. But on the other side, Yorkville's C.J. Bell has definitely been getting to Rochelle.
Rochelle doesn't quite know how to deal with C.J. Bell. C.J. Bell has just been trucking on through the Rochelle defense. That is a long pass, not good. Meant for number 84, Nathan Arias, the Hubs. And that'll send the Hubs down to fourth down.
So it looks like since there's about 9 yards to go, looks like we're going to once again see the punt formation, although.
A little bit of discussion down there. You can only wonder what they're talking about.
I was just going to say, so the guessing he was just kind of calling out, making sure that blockers, pick up their guys, but. And that's exactly why.
You can't give Rochelle too much time, because Yorkville will come in and charge right down there.
And that was an impressive punt block. You definitely saw where the, where there were holes in the line, where maybe the Rochelle special teams were getting a little nervous.
Just impressive block by Yorkville. The entirety of the stands here, Yorkville's team over on the bench, they all just got up and they started cheering. That was an amazing block, as we see Yorkville here now on the Rochelle 17-yard line.
First and 10, Yorkville.
Very convenient place to be sitting if you're going for your first touchdown.
Line up under the gun. They're going to send it right up the middle and see how much space they can gain with that carry was C.J. Bell.
A gain of 8 yards there, second and two, putting them on the 9-yard line. Yorkville on the 9-yard line, pardon me.
Sorry, Trent Delaney lining up. So he'll get credit for that carry, I believe.
Trent Delaney proving his worth as a running back, trying to fight tooth and nail through some of the Rochelle defense there. On the taking Delaney down there was number 35, Brandon Johnson.
Well, we definitely see Yorkville's game plan here. 23 CJ Bell just fighting for each yard, whereas you see 33 Delaney can make some moves on that outside.
You got your variety in your running backs coming out of Yorkville, and that's just what you need. Catching Rochelle off guard, obviously. They didn't know what to see from Delaney.
We'll go up the middle to catch him off guard. It's again, he's got space, still not on the ground. Delaney will gain a strong four.
Delaney, a name that Rochelle should now be fearing, as we've seen CJ Bell charging right on through the middle, like we've just been saying. Delaney proving that he can dance all around the Rochelle defense and even truck right on through, just unheard of by Rochelle right now.
What's very interesting is the fact that we've seen the, I mean the dominance that we're seeing right now, the very quick and unexpected dominance, is what got Rochelle their first 6 points.
In Yorkville coming out of the quarter, granted it wasn't a lot of time, it was still enough time to at least get a little bit of discussion on what Yorkville needs to do to get into their end zone.
I'm impressed with Yorkville's confidence, warming up both their long snapper and kicker.
Larry Midas coming back from getting a word with Coach Dan McGuire.
Well, these are the types of plays that can make or break when you've only got five in goal, or five to the goal line and second and goal.
Let's see what they decide to do. They're pushing right on through a mess of offensive and defensive players just massing right in front of the end zone. Brandon Lee with the carry there.
So it looks like it'll be a gain of about 2 yards, about 3 yards.
Yorkville is make or break right now. Third and goal. This isn't the situation where you want to pass the ball, but if it's going to catch Rochelle off guard, it might be worth it. What do you think, Evan?
Well, they keep those wide receivers on the outside. Now, Rochelle obviously puts a man out to cover him, but so far, Yorkville's been pretty readable, as they audible, may I add. And CJ Bell looks like he's been stopped.
Just shy of that end zone. That is a little heartbreaking. Fourth down, though, one to go. It was only a gain of 1 yard, so that 1 yard is just all they need to get across that end zone.
So kicker ready, helmet on. And I think Yorkville's going to go for it.
Hey, high risk, high reward, and if they can get even a one-point lead over Rochelle early on, it'll be enough momentum to get the ball rolling, but right now we're only talking about a touchdown. It'll be 6 points if they make it. Refs coming out onto the field.
Timeout, Rochelle.
Very wise timeout by Rochelle. You don't want to mess up here, Evan.
You saw the momentum swing that Yorkville, everybody on their feet. Rochelle just wanted to make sure that every man on the field knew what their job was and that they were going to get it done.
Coach Kevin Crandall definitely telling this team that they need to be on guard for this final rush by Yorkville.
They've just been absolutely dominating, though, when it comes to the defensive push. But now that we see Rochelle kind of on their back heels with the running game, you can't help but feel a little bit nervous, which is why I'm guessing they pulled the old timeout just to calm everybody down and keep things in perspective. Because Yorkville's been running it right up the middle.
If you can keep a level head in a situation where Yorkville is just bordering on that end zone, it's important to do that. Keep a level head and don't worry about Yorkville taking a lead if you can put an end to their rush. Here we go. Yorkville coming back out onto the field. Everybody's getting on their feet here in the stands. Fourth and goal.
Fourth and goal from the line. Doesn't get much more exciting in football than this, especially when you're down at home. You've got all the fans behind you. In motion.
In motion.
Pitch around the side. Delaney will find space. He's in the end zone. Touchdown,
Delaney. With another rush. A name that we will now be saying again most of the night. Trent Delaney dancing his way around Rochelle. Impressive.
High energy player. And you see that when he cuts around that left side. He can dip, dive, duck. Dip and dodge.
You can't forget that dodge. The dodge is the most important part there. Here in the stands, the Rowdies from Yorkville just rushing straight across the stands. And we see Cade Henry, power kicker here for Yorkville.
Don't want to jinx him, so I'll knock on wood first, but he has had some pretty impressive accuracy this year. Just about right down the middle for Yorkville.
And that extra point is good. Yorkville is in the lead just by a point, though.
Well, we've seen a lot of exciting football on both sides. Both sides have kind of gotten lucky where they've, you know, put a made a move on the field that caught the other defense off guard. You saw Rochelle very early with their strong pass game, and now Trent Delaney coming out, an unexpected variable in the game that Yorkville just used to score that touchdown. Yeah,
nice little secret weapon there in Trent Delaney. Very impressive running back. You're saying, you know, the five Ds, dodge, dip, duck, dive, and dodge again. He can do all that. C.J. Bell, very great for just pressing through when you're in the heart of the field, when you're on the 40-yard line, the 50-yard line. When you're around there, C.J. Bell is impressive just for trucking on through Rochelle's defense. And, you know, Rochelle's defense, is, as a matter of fact, they know when C.J. Bell's on the field, he'll charge right on through. And they've been picking up on putting an end to his rush just as soon as they can.
Well, when you see the both teams kind of, you know, getting that one up on each other, you got to think, you know, what's Rochelle got in store? Or, you know, what has Yorkville got in store to keep Rochelle down one?
In a match of one-upping, you got to find a way to chew up your opponent. And that ball goes up thanks to Cade Henry. Long kick right into the hands of number 25, Matt Albers, and getting brought down hard.
So Albers on the return for about 10 yards from where he caught it, 15. Blocking was, you know, held him off there for a few. So they've got some pretty good field percent, field advantage. But looks like they've still got a long way to claw back if they're going to try that ground game that they had a little earlier.
Yeah, we've seen a very significant swap of plays by Rochelle, at least early on in the game. When they got down into the third and fourth downs in their first possession, they switched to a passing game. Shout out to Noah Marchand being a great quarterback and, you know, letting his team know exactly what needs to be done. But now, in recent couple of plays here on Rochelle possession, they've been running it.
Yeah, like we just saw Harvey with a about a 4 or 5 yard carry. Gain of 4, I should say. And we still see Harvey, you know, in the backfield, in the huddle. So no doubt maybe they are trying something a little different.
When it comes to the great game of football, it does not hurt to try something different, especially if it will catch your opponent off guard.
And that'll be a run. Looks like there was a holding call on Rochelle.
Yep. Flag on the play.
So a far carry to about Yorkville's own 45, but there will be a flag.
You can see Yorkville starting to sweat out there. They're thanking the official for that stoppage of play, at least.
And it will be a holding on Rochelle. Just a lineman trying to get that outside edge, but got caught. So that'll be about 5 yards back. So they're right back where they started.
Yes, sir. We're looking at about second and, I do believe,
about 15.
15 with 7 minutes, 10 seconds remaining here. Rochelle might not need to worry while the lead is oh so slim, Yorkville 7 over Rochelle 6. They can adapt to anything too. Both teams are highly adaptive.
And the sweeper on the outside, play action.
Here we go, Matt Albers, the man, being brought down by 31, Austin Avery.
Those open field tackles are what Avery does best. You just saw it there, stopped what could have been a pretty damaging run.
Well, we've both seen it here, Evan. Rochelle, trying to run it. And when they do run it, the majority of the time they will be brought down. But on that other minority of the time, they can get away with a good run.
Once again, they're going to go to the air, try to get on the outside. Can't get the long ball, but it will go to 36. That was Palmer for the Hubs.
Not long enough, though. Fourth down, 6 to go on their Rochelle's own 36-yard line. There's a possibility we'll see Rochelle maybe pass it, but they're a little too far back. If they mess up, this is not the place you'd want to mess it up.
Not at all. Well, actually, it looks like the punt team is coming out onto the field. Well, we saw how badly this went for Rochelle last time, so you can definitely tell that they got a little bit of a pep talk, for lack of a better word.
Absolutely, but
once again, yeah, the offense pushing in. Yorkville.
Punt was good. Wozotski with the great catch there. Wozotski working his way, tumbling over the 40-yard line. Yeah, we just barely saw that there too. Rochelle, just before they sent that ball off, I couldn't quite get a read on who that was, but almost there blocking the punt again.
So it looks like Yorkville with some fairly neutral field advantage, but at least they're closer to center than they were for the earlier drive.
They could have been Rochelle on that last play and right on their 17-yard line, but nope, they are sitting pretty on the 39-yard line, it seems.
Going under the gun, so they'll send it up the middle with a pretty good play action at fake. Got to say, quick hands from Laramitis to be able to pull that off. Once again, Yorkville back to its old tricks, trying to go up the middle.
Sometimes going back to your old tricks never hurts. Just point this out. Tyler Amidas is a junior and both a quarterback, and very impressive plays we see from this junior quarterback, Tyler Amidas. He, as well as his team, just adapting to anything Rochelle puts out.
You'll find him going to the gun again. Different than the normal shotgun. And not a quick handoff. We'll go long
pass.
Oh, and almost just the fingertips. Tended for 8-4, Jason Lewan.
A little heart-wrenching there. Brought down by Chris Clark from the Hubs. Nothing much to worry about. Third down, 8 to go for Yorkville. We might see him run it here.
Might as well gain a few yards and try to get closer to it. You've seen Delaney's ability to get around that outside and at least pick up around 9 to 10 yards when you only need 8. Well, that's what you got to do. So an opportunity for Rochelle to get a stop.
And from what we've seen, if Yorkville gets in close, it's going to be a much needed stop.
And there it is.
Yorkville decided to run it. Couldn't quite do it.
Tackled for a loss.
Well, Shell may be down by a point, Evan, but they are not going to let Yorkville get one more, it seems.
The 4th and 9.
And we sent out the punting team, it looks like.
Back to receive for Rochelle is Metzger.
We see on the Yorkville side of things, That was number 41.
Spotted about the 50-yard line.
That'll come out. He's actually starting, not the original starting punter for Yorkville. Just comes right off his right foot. We'll go out about the 50-yard line. So great field positioning for Rochelle to possibly go to the air and
right
get in the end zone.
Dead center of the field. They have a great chance of making a nice rushing play here. Rush it or pass it. Rochelle can do it all.
They'll line up with a single receiver. Under the gun. Pass opportunity.
Going deep. Very great tackle there by
pass intended for Alberts.
It was Dylan Wozotski there on the tackle. Or Brandon Reifstek, pardon me.
So with the incomplete pass, that'll bring up 2nd and 10. Clock ticks just at around 3.5 minutes. Left in the quarter, 1-point game.
Very rare thing to see in a game of football, but it's just been tooth and nail all night.
Definitely, it's definitely a good show of how close this game is.
It's just a game of strategy. That's all it comes down to. We see one wide receiver again.
Oh, with the pitch back, play action.
Very great, and he's running it. That was number 42 running it, Aaron Metzger.
And he's got to get him about eight.
Third and one. We're definitely going to see a running back at least try to fight his way through the Yorkville defense.
Yorkville trying to make a stop here with third and one to go. The pitch on the outside, it worked once, it'll work again.
Aaron Mertzer again.
Stretching for the line, but I guess he didn't really know where he was. Saw that extension trying to get the first down. He had it by a few yards. So right around at their own 34, Yorkville backed up on their heels for two plays in a row.
Yorkville really going to start to kick it into overdrive here. They want to stop a great, not a great offensive rush, but from what we've seen in last quarter.
And that pitch will come around the outside. Won't quite get the turn. Oh, he will. Broken tackle. And it'll make some space. So Alberts will take that one.
Austin Avery putting an end to that rush by Albers, and a much needed stop as that second down, three to go. Rochelle getting closer and closer to Yorkville's end zone, 27 yard line in the Foxes territory. Foxes are taking a much needed timeout. And what we're gonna see, Evan, is Rochelle, they're gonna start changing their strategy up. We've seen them rush it now. We've seen a couple of passes here and there, but right now, I'm thinking they're gonna start to pass it.
I mean, you've seen the run game work a little bit, but when they've taken it to the air, you've seen these big plays happen, and with big plays come momentum. And well, if anybody who's watching football can tell you that momentum can be the only decider in a game this close.
Not only that, but momentum can change on a dime. We saw Yorkville at the beginning of the quarter. They had momentum. They were rolling into it. But it seems that their momentum has been taken away, and Rochelle picked it right back up as they're pressing the offense right now with about 2.5 minutes remaining here in the half. It's going to be impressive to see what Yorkville dishes out against Rochelle here.
At both points in time, both of these teams have looked like they might run away with it, and as we can see, both teams kind of countered and found their way back into it. Yorkville's defense has just been unstoppable, as well as Rochelle's. Well, right now it looks like Yorkville's on top.
Right now, especially Yorkville being at home, they got their home team advantage, home field advantage, pardon me, and if you can hear it, the home team and the crowd is definitely getting behind Yorkville. They want their defense. We see Metzger again with the ball, flag on the play.
And I can already tell you what the flag was for. Matt Albers with the hold. Just about tackled the defender rushing in.
Well, we're probably going to see here Rochelle go back a couple yards.
So it does look like that foul will be on number 25, Albers, for that hold in the backfield.
When it comes to pushing the offense, you cannot be making mistakes like that, especially when you only got so many yards to go for your first down. But now we see Rochelle being knocked back, second and 20 now.
Sorry, it was a block in the back was the call on Albers, so that'll be actually a 10-yard penalty. As a deep drop back, pass goes up, and no go.
Little shy of
some great textbook pass coverage.
That was intended for number 16, Eichner. Could not quite get it, but great placement there on the field, though. He was reading where that ball was going, but he just couldn't get there in time.
Credit to Herbst for using his height. 6'1", steps in that defensive back position. He's got a few plays that really attest to his skill of being able to get that coverage, but not be so in your face that it can end up in a possibility of a pass interference call.
There is something there to be said on Yorkville defense when it does come to quarterback Noah Mershon going for a pass. Yorkville will be there wherever that ball is going to go.
And that small bullet tried to get it in.
And there we go, too. Yorkville reading where that ball was going, no matter how fast it was. Trying to find who that ball was going to. Found it. And just throw Rochelle off their wheels.
That pass intended for number 85 from Rochelle Blake Albers. Can only imagine brother of Matt Albers.
I would believe so. If they both play ball equally as good, you got to get the team of Albers out there. Just about 2 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Yorkville still has a lead, but we see fourth and 20 here. Rochelle on the Yorkville's own 44-yard line. Ball going up. And looks like that's a nice catch. And he's going to field it. That was Dylan Wozotsky fielding that ball. So we're going to start over again. Yorkville is going to have possession here with 1 minute and 50 seconds left. And they have a whole football field away for another touchdown.
Going to try to move in and get this score.
You think it'd be an effective way to, or an effective way you would think to get downfield would be passing it, but you don't want to risk getting an incomplete pass or even worse, a turnover there. Tyler Amite is definitely going to have to read his team and where they are in a matter of seconds.
Well, they're back in the shotgun once again for the pass play. Looks like there will be a hold.
Juan did make that pass. It was a complete pass, but there was a flag on the play. I'm going to agree with you, Evan. It might have been a hold there.
Didn't quite catch a number. And we're waiting for a call from the refs. We'll be holding
against Yorkville
on Foxes. All right, well, 5 yards, 10-yard penalties, I'm sorry. So Yorkville will find itself in a little of a uncomfortable situation.
In a bit of a crunch, but nothing we haven't seen a team get out of before. First and 10, ball on their own 15-yard line. I mean, you can't get back further than that, really. You really hope you don't want to go back further than that, especially if there's a fumble on the play. 90 seconds ticking down on the clock. Looking like they're going to run it. Gets caught up in the defense. Can't quite get a number on who that was.
Number 30, Brandon Lee on the carry.
Looks like that was number 30. Brandon Lee, more of a fullback positioner. But, it kind of makes you wonder, I guess, C.J. Bell taking a break till half.
If you can do it, definitely save your secret weapons till the second half. And right now, Yorkville's in the lead, and they're on the possession. And they might be on possession and going into that second half. It'll be impressive to see what comes out of it. But for right now, we're talking about the present. We see, I do believe that's Brandon Lee again, fighting his way, breaking tackles, getting through and going for a run, being brought down, though, by number 34. That was Delaney, pardon me, still. Trent Delaney with a great run.
So looks like that it'll be a timeout for Yorkville. So they're going to try to hold on to the clock. Looks like they're definitely going for the score.
Well, Yorkville made a great, great pass there. Trent Delaney running it. A great run there, I should say. He was running it, made it way far out of their end zone, out of that awkward area where they don't want to be. And right now, third and second, with 30 seconds remaining here, looking like they might get their first down after being set back that far, Evan.
Well, if they do get that first, you know that although accuracy is tough at those distant throws, Laramitis is a quarterback with an arm. So we'll have to see what Yorkville's got in store, because right now looking at the formation, I don't know that I can tell. Lining up under the gun has kind of been a game changer for Yorkville.
I'm not sure what's going on out here, but there's something to be said for Ty Laramitis, and he is one courageous junior and a quarterback.
Well, they pull the audible. They'll send Bell with a hurry.
C.J. Bell back out.
Sorry, it was Delaney. My apologies.
Oh, sorry, I followed your lead there. But hey, still Trent Delaney with a little hop, skip, and a jump there.
Well, like we were saying before, kid's got feet, that's for sure.
Hey, that's a Yorkville first down, by the way.
Looks like they'll call another timeout. So Yorkville definitely going for the score.
Yorkville desperately wants to get some insurance points over Rochelle here. We're going to see all of the A-team players coming out here just to get them as far across the field as they can in these about 20 seconds remaining. We're going to see CJ Bell out here. We might see Trent Delaney. He was already out here before. And don't forget about Jason Lawan, a great wide receiver, standing tall at 6'6", by the way.
23 seconds on the clock.
Oh. Now, can't quite see it, a little bit of confusion going on, but there is 23 seconds on the clock. Pardon me. Rochelle here might be reeling. Yorkville picked up momentum again. They're sending out their A team, as we can only imagine. And Rochelle's going to put a stop to it as fast as they can before half.
It's going to be a long way to go in 23 seconds, though. They're going to need a few big plays.
Anything that can get you riding high before the half and riding high when you get back into the half is great. Laramidas, long pass. Lawan making the catch. Complete pass. That was on the 45-yard line. Great pass by Laramidas.
He will get out of bounds, too, so a twofer on that one. Big play and stops the clock so they can continue marching down the field. The Foxes looking hot right now.
With a string of luck, the Foxes coming in out of nowhere, bringing that in, Jason Lawan and Tyler Aramidas.
And they'll line up in the shotgun, looking for another pass. They're going to try to go deep again.
Hey, if it worked one time, do it again. That's all right, though. Did not work that time. Jason Lawan was there. Was a little too shallow for him. He was getting covered, pressured, actually, too, by Palmer from the Hubs.
You got to be very careful with the if it ain't broke, don't fix it policy in football. That can end to, in any number of possible fumbles, turnovers, interceptions. Got to be very careful as a coach. But McGuire showing that he's got the tenacity to make those gutsy play calls and stick with what's working.
Absolutely. We're seeing again in the shotgun formation. We could very well see Leonidas turn around and hand it off. But what was that, Evan?
So it seems like they're looking past once again, trying to go over the center, wrapped up quickly. Great pass coverage from the Hubs. That was number 30. Lee on the, was the attended receiver. Looks like Greg Ricketts for the Hubs. I'm sorry, that was Metzger for the Hubs, doing double duty as a linebacker as well.
Very impressive. It's great seeing somebody, especially on defense, playing multiple positions. Shows great adaptability. We've been talking about that all night, but what Yorkville needs to do, they need to adapt out of doing the they can try to pass it one more time, but they're on the third down. They got 10 yards to go. They need to at least get a couple of yards in.
Looks like they're going to go pass again. I think they're going to try, and
that's not what you want to see.
Once that knee touches the ground in IHSA, play is over, so clock will run, and looks like they'll let it run out. So the teams will run off the field for halftime.
What we've seen there was a great show of athleticism throughout that second quarter by both teams and a great show of adaptation. That's the end of the first half. We're going to go to commercial break here. Keep it here on Fox Valley TV.
Wow, these are really good.
You act surprised. Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Now, come on.
I know, 2 seconds. Hang on, just stand still. Stand still, love.
One second.
I know. Just
come on.
Go.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you just as you are.
Welcome back to Fox Valley TV. And if you're just joining us, we are coming back from the half. And Yorkville is in the lead over the Rochelle Hubs 7-6. I'm Tom Molding, and alongside me this evening is Evan Wiseman.
We've seen some very exciting football, Tom. It's been absolutely incredible, both teams battling it back and forth, mainly defensively, but we have seen some strong run games from both sides. The pass defense, though, showing a little too much for either side. Both have young quarterbacks. Both have fantastic arms, but just cannot get it over the coverage that you see. Right now, Yorkville definitely on top, although the scoreboard doesn't show it, but is right now 7-6. They are up one. And I think that lead might get extended unless Rochelle, flips things around. But if I were to decide the game on who was going into half, looks like Yorkville might be my winner.
I'd say coming out of the half, Yorkville definitely had the upper hand. They had the momentum. They know what they got to do over Rochelle now. You mentioned it, both quarterbacks, young quarterbacks, but they're both mature. They both have a good read on their team. And they know what they need to do to help their team succeed.
I got to say, a little asterisk on that, though, is Rochelle is not a team to be counted out, though. This team is a strong team, small team, but we saw them take it to Yorkville early in this game. Rochelle, if there was a team to do it, I think this might be the team to do it.
This might be the team to do it, absolutely. Rochelle coming into the game, as you just said, they came in and they swept for their first touchdown. No extra point off that first touchdown. The score is still 7-6, Yorkville in the lead.
And a boot on that one, so back to receive. Rochelle setting up space, open tackle is broken.
Here we go, Matt Albers, definitely with a good carry there.
So he'll fall out about the 36-yard line.
All right, so we're officially underway again. Let's see what Rochelle has to offer coming out of the half. Right now, we see Matt Albers again back on the field, a strong player, another player besides Albers to mention from Rochelle is Eichner. I do believe I see him on the field. Eichner's been great all night, great wide receiver. Now we see Albers running it.
What?
Oh, hold up, that's not Albers, that's number 20. Being brought down hard, Alex Harvey, newcomer on the field tonight.
What a crazy broken tackle and just an explosion of speed coming down the middle. That caught me by surprise for sure.
I was definitely not looking out for that, but when he started running, he was running on a wing and a prayer there, Evan. He saw the end zone. He saw red. He put everything he had into that sprint.
The Roselle defense, or offense, I'm sorry, is looking strong with that run game after that positioning. And Albers trying to do some magic again, cannot get around that outside.
Now, our predictions might have been wrong. I mean, not saying Yorkville, their defense is not, I'm not saying they're not ready, but, you know, that might have caught them by surprise. Alex Harvey with a great run. Yorkville definitely maybe a little on edge, but, you know, that edge might give them enough adrenaline, enough gears turning in their brain to pick out on their defense. I mean, they're getting close. Rochelle is second and 8 on the 25-yard line in Yorkville territory.
Oh, and another great run.
I think
run.
That's Albers. Albers
25, Albers on the carry.
Going down just shy of the end zone.
Well, they've found a position, that play action that they've got, where you can run Albers or try to fall back on that right side, but looks like Rochelle has found exactly what they were looking for.
Albers found his meaning right there. He found where he needed to go, and gosh darn it, he did it. He got so close. He's just 2 yards off that end zone, and Rochelle seeing red, they're gonna go for it.
And the dive in looks, it's good. 25 Albers for the Rochelle touchdown.
And now we see Rochelle take the lead again, coming straight out of the half. 10 minutes, 17 seconds in. Rochelle 12 over Yorkville 7.
And it looks like they'll be most likely going for two here, being down. Have they just been down? I'm sorry, 1 point. And I believe so, considering the quarterback stepping in. So looks like the Hubs are going to go for two.
Nothing wrong with that. I mean, especially after being down for so long, they want to get that insurance over Yorkville, make sure Yorkville does not get anywhere near them in terms of points again.
There go Mershon for the pass again, and what a hand looked out. That was 88, if I'm correct. I didn't quite catch the number on that one. I've got 69, Andy.
Badalamente, there you go.
Thank you.
Great hand on there, though. And great hand on Andy Badalamente there. No, that was impressive.
If only I could move as fast up the roster as his reaction time was, as fast just to reach out and get that big paw and knock down that ball.
So we see again both two-point conversions that Rochelle has tried for tonight. They have failed, not for lack of trying, though. Yorkville's been on point with their defense. Current score now, Rochelle 12 over Yorkville 7. So if it comes around to it again, and Yorkville goes on the when Yorkville goes on the offense, here we go, right now, getting ready to receive, Yorkville will get a touchdown, and they'll find themselves in the lead again. With a, I do believe it'd be a two-point lead, if my math is correct.
This is going to be a do-or-die moment for Yorkville. They've got to score early and score often if they're going to pull this off, because right now Rochelle must have just had some words of wisdom. And for the first time, a kick has not been bobbled by Yorkville.
It was a square catch by C.J. Bell back on the field. And I do believe they are going to drop that ball around the 40-yard line. So Yorkville, again, finding themselves in neutral territory after completing that receive, by the way. First time, as you mentioned, tonight.
So they start their drive at the 41 with an eye package to wide receivers.
The opportunities are limitless here for Yorkville's offensive team here.
Still on his feet.
Oh my goodness. Impressing even me up here in the press box. That was,
once again, Delaney making some moves.
Trent Delaney does not cease to impress. He's always on his feet, even when he shouldn't be. That man has a never-say-die attitude when it comes to running that ball.
His point, his yards post-contact are fairly impressive with, you know, 5 to 6 yards average coming off of the initial impact from the play.
Here we go, first down again, first and 10 for Yorkville.
Gonna go pass.
Incomplete pass, good read there on Rochelle. That was number 10 blocking that, Chris Clark.
Second down.
So it'll come up second down, still 10 yards. Yorkville will be back. Around second down, they've normally gone with a pretty sure run play with either Delaney around the sides or Bell up the middle. With this eye, they can do either. You can't really, you know, expect either. Yorkville pulling a little play action, as we just saw.
We see him hand it off to, I do believe that's Delaney out there. Delaney with a quick feet, bobbing and weaving through the Rochelle defense. Always fun to watch that. That's Riley Williams bringing him down there. And Rochelle getting a little, digging their heels into the ground a little bit. Third and one for Yorkville. If they just send even one running back and he could just jump through just a little bit, Yorkville will get a fresh set of downs, and that's exactly what they need going for this offensive rush again.
Once again, you know, they're going with the run. And still a strong game, although not as big as the initial few runs, but enough for a Yorkville first down.
It was Brandon Lee on the carry.
Lee's run is good for the Foxes.
Brandon Lee awarding the Foxes the first down with that great charge in there. Ball on the 37-yard line. Yorkville eking closer to that end zone. Facing down a right through Rochelle's defense. You can sure bet Lyra Minus is going to do whatever he can to make sure his team gets through.
It's like a keeper on that right side. And interesting play call from Yorkville. Trying to get out of the outside. A quarterback not known entirely for his speed, known more for his arm. Trying to get that left side. So what happens is, I'm guessing, a Yorkville team is not used to running the play action around that side, so I'm guessing a little bit of a panic mode.
I can imagine that running along the side is definitely panic territory for Yorkville. And Rochelle, I mean, with their defense, they can sure see where Yorkville's not comfortable. Hey, we see a nice run here. We see, is that Delaney out there? Yes, Delaney, he's going for a run.
And not quite. Looks like he had about a yard short. Looks like he might have stepped out a little early.
We get a final spot. We got a flag on the play.
Oh, there is a flag on the play. Not something you want to see. We'll see what the ref has to say, but a great jumping, leaping catch there. We do have a jumping tackle, I should say, but injured hub. Can't quite get a read on him. Our view is obscured. It's number 36 now that we see him. That is Brandon Johnson. Oh, pardon me, Kaywan Palmer. It's a hold against Yorkville, too, by the way. All this action coming to you right now.
So Yorkville will move back 10 yards as we get the official's timeout through, and hopefully all players are okay.
Right now, looking over at Kaywan Palmer, he doesn't look like he's in too much pain. I cannot judge this from here. I'm not a doctor, and I'm also up off the field very high.
Well, they both made strong hits, good tackles.
That was not for a lack of trying. Go on.
Right now, Yorkville, as you can see, a little, once they find the great opportunity, they do have a little, kind of mental lapse. They got a few young players on this team.
Oh,
and
here
one
we go.
Of them just making the hold.
Kaywan Palmer walking off the field on his own power. And no, you're right. If Yorkville creates their space, Evan, they can definitely pull off a play like that again, which is amazing to see from a high school level. And Foxes are being sent back to the original line of scrimmage now. Let's hope they can hit the reset button and do all that again, but better.
Well, it's only 2nd and 10. We found them get out of this situation before. Now that they're in the eye, once again, we'll probably see that option, I'm guessing, around right side.
All right, Larry Minus going back deep. LaJuan cannot quite get there in time, being pressured out by Eichner.
Right now, both quarterbacks are getting a little bit hesitant in their throwing as they seem to be going over target more times than not.
There is such thing as a biting off more than you can chew. I'm not saying that Tyler Minus is doing that, but he's taking a fair share of time to figure out where he needs to go. And nothing wrong with that, but you just got to make sure you don't lose any yards there. That was just an incomplete pass, thankfully. But if, heaven forbid, Tyler Minus finds himself in a position to be sacked, he'll be kicking himself about that in the following defensive play.
Good pass, strong pass.
Effective pass.
84. Jason Ruan grab that out of the air. And step out of bounds. So clock stops. About 7:45 left. 7:43, I should say. So Yorkville grabbing that first down from the air.
And Yorkville finding a way to get that first down miraculously. We find themselves back in it.
And they'll go with the run out of the eye again. Delaney making moves, still not down.
Ooh.
And he'll hit the ground hard.
Delaney has some hearts there.
So it looks like, I believe I've got number 10, Chris Clark.
Yeah.
And the boost gonna credit it to Steven Eichner from Rochelle.
For that great run there again by Delaney. Wow, second down, one to go on the Hubs 16-yard line. It'll be interesting to see what quarterback Larry Minus has to do about this. Hands it off.
goes for the strong run right up the middle. That's 30 once again. We find them going to Brandon Lee to try to get those power yards. Good run, strong, that's for sure.
Hey, ball's on the 11-yard line. We're getting ever closer for Yorkville being first and goal or even in that end zone. Rochelle definitely on edge.
Yorkville in the eye once again. They'll send it off for the run that did not go very far. Delaney wrapped up in the backfield.
Nothing wrong with that. If anything, it's actually a loss yardage. I was going to say it was a gain, but I was proven wrong. Second down though, 12 to go. Not bad, especially when you're on the 13-yard line. You could be in a lot worse position on your second down in midfield. This is not where you want to be. But with being so close to that end zone, anything could happen here with Yorkville.
Well, you got to remember that a kick only puts you 2 points down. So Yorkville will line up once again in the eye under the gun. And they'll be going pass. Up
long
in the air. Brings it down. Oh, intercepted. We're waiting for a call.
Very confused.
There's been no whistle. So
no
turnover bag on the field. And they will call it.
It is a touchback interception.
Okay. Rochelle will grab the ball in that back corner. And a turnover in what appeared to be a miracle.
Well, from one very confused sportscaster to I'm just flabbergasted. That was an impressive play there.
Two players went up. It seemed like Yorkville had it, and then all of a sudden, purple jersey, or white and purple, popped out of the pile of two, and next thing you know, it's a touchback, so Rochelle will line up under the gun. Motion
wow.
Once again, 25 with the carry, and a whole lot
of space. Away. You see that again. That's number 20. That's Alex Harvey, Evan.
Just seems like everybody on the Rochelle bench can run the ball aggressively down the middle.
Rochelle doesn't have a large student section here tonight or a large visiting section, but I'll tell you what, everybody over there in that smaller section of bleachers, they're getting into it. This game is only a 5-point game, too, 7-12, but Rochelle definitely ensuring that Yorkville cannot score again. Of course, Yorkville scores again, they'll be in the lead.
Smaller school stepping up. They've got everything to prove.
Right now, it's conference play. Everything to prove. They got nothing to lose. Both teams, by the way, 1-1.
Oh, and a fumble.
Who will come out of this?
Still losing the pile. Yorkville saying that they have it. It looks like it'll stay. Looks like a white jersey's got it, so it'll stay. Number 68, Kyle Esther, I believe that's the center. Will pull that one in.
They lost a yard. Well, you could have lost more yards, but right now we're looking at 2nd and 11 with about 4:45 here left in the third. As I previously stated, Rochelle still in the lead, 12-7, and coming off of a great run by Alex Harvey. I can't even count how many rushing yards he has here tonight, Evan.
And once again, they'll put it on the ground, so he'll gain a few. Looks like about a gain of 3 with that carry.
Number 20, Alex Harvey.
So once again, Harvey pulling up the middle, this time a little less successful than before, obviously, but he creates space after contact, and that's the important part if you're trying to gun it up the middle.
Absolutely. Making space and having confidence, the two key things, the two key motives that you need when you're running it up the middle.
And once again, in motion. Play action goes to, that's 25 for the Hubs, that's Albers. And he'll grab 4 more yards.
All right, well, we're looking at about 4th down, I would believe, and 4 to go.
Safe to say. So it looks like they're bringing out the special teams, although they haven't made a line change. Well, no, Michonne will actually step out into the huddle. So they're going to try to go for it here on fourth down.
What's wrong with that, man? With how Rochelle's been playing, I think they can do it. Finding a strong defense in Yorkville, putting an end to that rush in Yorkville.
Just a wall.
Wow, we see. Who is that? That's number 56 out there. I think that was Lazarek Jackson on the stop there. Very proud of himself and his team. Lazarek Jackson, captain for Yorkville. Great stop.
And Yorkville will take this opportunity. So, using this momentum, first and 10, they line up in the eye. Looks like it'll go to a run. Little dancing in the backfield, and Delaney will, looks like, pick up about 2 yards.
Nothing wrong with a gain of a few yards on your first down. A clock ticks down past 3 minutes here. Yorkville on their offensive possession. Tyler Arenas coming back, having a word with Coach McGuire. Definitely wonder what he's going to do here.
They'll line up in the eye once again for that option. Two receivers on the sides.
Variety is the spice of life, and when you're coming to football and you're trying to get a leg up on your opponent, variety is the key. Pass. Oh, and a great pass for opportunity. That was Brady Fisher, if I'm not mistaken. Wonderful catch.
Definitely got to start keeping stats for on-target shots, because that was just perfect. Fortunately, you know, with the way Rochelle's defense has been, you can't blame any of these Yorkville wide receivers if they're, you know, a little bit antsy once the ball touches their hand, because they are ready for a pretty impact.
They're ready to be brought down, which, again, is not a bad thing to happen. If you're not expecting to be tackled, you could get hurt really bad. So it's good that Yorkville's being on edge, but they can't be too jumpy, especially when they're facing a team like Rochelle. Long pass now. Great catch. Wow, that's good enough for a first down. Who is that?
Makes up for it. That was 31, who originally had the first, Austin Avery.
Oh, my goodness. Austin Avery proving his worth tonight.
Playing double duty as well as a linebacker and a tight end on occasional split plays. So Yorkville mixing it up a little bit, and it is working. So there'll be a timeout on the official. So there was a light injury on the Hubs. That was Bell Bennett, if I'm correct. So he'll get off the field under his own power, which is good to see.
Always good to see that, especially concerning an injury.
And back in the eye, they'll hand off again, going right up the middle with space after contact. Grab 2 or 3 yards. That looked like it was C.J. Bell, if I'm correct.
Being brought down by Chris Clark. I do believe you're right with that being C.J. Bell, and just shy of that first down line.
So the Foxes, who are currently on a slow but steady push, inch ever closer to the end zone.
Both teams just fighting tooth and nail. Nobody wanting to come away with a loss tonight. It's impressive.
Back in a deep shotgun. Oh, I'm sorry, undergun with a deep running back. So he's got the run up. Space is there.
Coming off of it. Breaking away for a first down.
So Lanakis from the Hubs will make the stop, but the Foxes will get a first down.
Rochelle's really got to dig their ankles in, and they got to prepare for a fight, both of mental and physical aptitudes. These teams are fighting a very strategic game. It's all in your head, and you got to read what the opposite team is doing. Rochelle right now has to read what Yorkville is doing, and they got to put an end to it. That's where your mentality comes into it.
Well, easier said than done, especially when they've got carries like this. Although Rochelle doing a very good job at stopping at the line, seemed like it was only a yard or so gain.
That was Delaney on the carry. And Alex Harvey also pulling out some double duty, it seems. Second and 9 here for Yorkville as the clock ticks down past 20 seconds. Clock not stopping, by the way. Yorkville ready to go on maybe one last ditch effort of a run for a play.
There's a little confusion on the field.
Gotta be safe here. That's definitely going to be a delay of game penalty if they're not safe. Well, that's the end of the third quarter in a very confusing way, but that's what's going to happen, I guess. Fox has let the time expire, and they're going to go into the fourth quarter on possession. Well, from Yorkville's Campbell Stadium, this is Fox Valley TV. Stay right here. We'll be right back.
Mom, can we get some ice cream?
Please, Mom, please.
No, we're having dinner soon.
Please.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you just as you are.
Now, come on, Mom. Come on.
Right. I know, 2 seconds. Hang on, just stand still. Stand still, love.
This is insane.
Come on. 1 second, I know.
Just,
he's
okay,
go, go, go.
No. Boys, hang on, boys.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you just as you are.
All right, welcome back to Fox Valley TV, and you are just about to witness the fourth and final quarter of a very mental and physical game of football here tonight between the Yorkville Foxes and the Rochelle Hubs.
Both teams have a lot of opportunities to either succeed or fail, and it's going to come down to moments like this as they try to push up the middle. Once again, Yorkville, Brandon Lee on that carry. He's putting in work these last few plays. We saw even before we just went to break that he was getting those 3 and 4 yard gains pretty accurately. As he averages about 3 to 4 yards a carry.
Yep.
As a fullback, that's the stats you want to see, that every carry you're getting those positive yards.
Helps you out, and if you're a fullback, especially getting those 3 or 4 gains a carry, that's exactly what you want to see. Third down, 3 to go. Fox is on the hub, 20-yard line. That's good enough for a first down. It looks like if he doesn't get pushed back any further, maybe straddling that line just a little bit.
And the whistle came up. Flag hit the field, did not catch what it was. So Brandon Johnson had the tackle, though.
I could not quite catch what that was either. We'll definitely see it soon enough.
So it looks like we have a holding on Yorkville.
Not what you want to see. A little bit of upset fans here in the Yorkville stands. Just a 5-yard penalty.
Well, this is a game of wits, definitely, and holding is not what you need, especially when you've got two running backs who can put so many yards up just to get pushed back.
It might be all for naught, especially here on the third down, 3rd and 9. We see Laramidas here in the shotgun formation.
And he will roll out.
Run it with a good straight pass at least. It's a good catch and falls into the end zone, but there's a flag on the play.
That is definitely pass interference on Rochelle. Over the shoulder on the run while he's sweeping on the bootleg. There are professional athletes who cannot do that successfully. And credit to, even though it was incomplete, credit to Laramidas for putting the ball on target.
Laramidas throwing a shot out of desperation. Pass interference, it is called, by the way, but that shot out of desperation found its mark and found the end zone.
Well, sometimes you just find muscle memory like he just did, and the pass was so good, it causes a Rochelle defender to go into panic mode. Next thing you know, you see a bad foul. Yorkville's on the line. You know, they've got about 13 yards to go.
Very impressive. I'll tell you, there are not many plays that will make a person react how it you might not have seen it, but I just kind of reacted there a lot. As we see, that's that Laramidas running the ball.
Got plenty of blockers, but cuts inside to get a few yards extra.
That was Delaney, Trent Delaney on the carry. My apologies there, but.
So Williams from the Hubs will pull that pulled Delaney down. So they've still got a little bit of space to work, but about 6 yards until the goal line. Yorkville is feeling excited.
Yorkville's definitely feeling a touchdown. They definitely want one, and right now we might see him get it.
Got to be very careful in situations like this. It ended up in an interception thrown last time.
If you get too excited, you might not make it, but definitely handing that ball off, learning from their mistakes. Not sure where that is.
Right up the middle, did not see who had it. Delaney comes up with the ball, so Delaney with a carry.
Alex Harvey on the stop there, pulling off a great stop as a linebacker. Ball is on the four. Third and one for Yorkville. I mean, you can carry it 1 yard. I mean, ball's on the 4 yard line. As long as you get that extra bit of batch of downs, if you can't get it in the end zone, that's all you need. But we'll see what Yorkville can do here.
And he will shed the block and fly into the end zone. Touchdown, Yorkville.
Yeah, Yorkville coming off the field, definitely excited off that play. Very, very nice celebration as they send out the punting team. We see Cade Henry back there, the kicker for Yorkville. Great to see Yorkville definitely fighting all their way across the field for that touchdown. And now they're in the lead again, and we might see a two-point lead after Cade Henry closes up.
So, another great kick right up the middle.
It is good.
So, 14-12, two-point lead. And Yorkville will be set to kick.
Rochelle, like not for a lack of trying, they are trying to put an end to anything Yorkville is dishing out. We're definitely going to see what Rochelle has to dish out on this possession now. Yorkville, if they want to maintain this lead with the remaining 9.5 minutes in the game, Yorkville's going to stay on edge. They've got to read everything that quarterback Noah Mershon is putting out from the hubs. You got to keep a lookout, by the way. Number 20, Alex Harvey. He's come away with so many runs here tonight, Evan.
It's been a few big plays that have definitely led to some momentum swings, but Yorkville feeling very good. They just got to be very careful about this kick return, though, because remember, Harvey is on the field.
It'll be exciting as these minutes start to tick down here in the final quarter. This is where football gets exciting. Both teams want to win with a slight margin like this. Cade Henry puts that ball up, kind of a midway kick, finds its way deep backfield. And
Johnson has space. He'll make it to about the 45.
36, Palmer, the return man for the Foxes. Production for the Hubs brought down by number 8, Justin Williams.
So number 8, Williams on that tackle. And Rochelle will step in. Not exactly do or die here. It's only 2 points with about 9 minutes left in the game.
Rochelle could play a very relaxed game of football right now, even though they are down. If they play it relaxed, but they really push it there at the end, we could definitely see them pull away with the win. I do believe I saw that was number 22 on the carry there. That might be Dante Contreras. That was 20, Alex Harvey, pardon me. Alex Harvey, again, impressing. I don't know how he manages to break away, but he does it all right.
Well, credit to that front line who has been just creating a whole lot of space for him to get through.
So much for playing that relaxed game of football until, you know, they get to that end zone. They're just bringing it right to Yorkville's front door and saying, we're here, man.
Well, Rochelle has been making space. So they are in a ways, you know, following your motto, keeping it relaxed. But, you know, when you see space, you just got to go for it. As once again, they go to carry, and that'll go right up the middle. So trying something different, but not quite working for Rochelle. It's Matt Albers on the carry and made it about an inch. Credit for the tackle set to Captain Sean Kuhn. You know, back in the huddle is Rochelle.
Definitely trying to strategize. We might see Noah Mershon pass it, but from how we set up right now, probably not. Hands the ball off, actually.
And not quite the 40-yarder we were expecting whenever he touched the ball, but Harvey will at least gain about 8. So that'll set up for 3rd and 2.
Well, with 8 minutes on the clock, time keeps ticking down. The Hubs are on the 21-yard line, and both teams not wanting to come away tonight with a loss. Both teams have come this far, at least. Rochelle's held on to the lead for a longer time than Yorkville. But now Yorkville, with that fresh lead, they might want to hold on to it for as long as they can, as we see, can't see who was carrying it there.
42, looks like Metzger had that?
I do believe that was Metzger, and he's getting kind of pressured out.
So yeah, he was pushed out, so the clock will stop at 7:45. And that'll be first and goal for Rochelle at about the 10-yard line. Yorkville's got to be very careful. This run game for Rochelle has been almost unstoppable.
Yorkville has got to find a way to stop that Rochelle rush. If they're going to try to run it up the middle, you got to get all your defensive, you got to get all your linebackers, anybody who is available to block. You can't do that.
The motion jumps and works. That extended switch from 25 that they've been using, Matt Albers. You saw him wrap around for the first time, I think, all game. And Yorkville, who's been trying to obviously get that upper edge, jumps a little too early.
Well, now Yorkville has a little bit more time to sweat now. First and goal on the 5-yard line. Like I was saying, though, if they're going to try to, pardon me, if Rochelle is going to try to run it up the middle, get anybody who's available from that defensive line to stop that ball runner, but you got to be aware, if you're going to do that, you got to look out for fake outs.
I was going to say, worst comes to worst, if there is any problems, Rochelle, who will try to send it up the middle and get stopped. If they do get stopped, go 4 and out for these four. I was going to say that they have the opportunity to kick the field goal, take the lead by a point, but we haven't seen Rochelle's field goal unit
yet.
We
actually have not. They've been trying for 2-point conversions all night after their touchdowns. Wasn't really a gain of any yards there. We're still first and goal on the 5-yard line. Yorkville only has 2 more attempts to stop this Rochelle rush.
Austin Avery with that last stop. Not just a 2-position player, a 2-sport player as well.
Yes, we've seen Austin Avery in the past season play basketball. Very all-around sports guy.
So Rochelle lining up. They'll send motion. The pitch is quick. He's got a lot of room to work with. Touchdown.
That's a touchdown.
Number 25 for Rochelle. Matt Albers picks up his 2nd of the day.
Not for lack of trying. Rochelle has been really wanting that 2nd touchdown, especially coming off of the intercepted pass from however long ago that was. Rochelle did not want Yorkville to take the lead, and right now they're proving it. 18-14, pardon me.
Well, it looks like we've got a few extras coming out on the field. Could this be the field goal unit?
It'll be something that is definitely unseen. I mean, if it doesn't work twice, you might want to send out your field goal.
Well, if there's something that Yorkville has, minus the last play, unfortunately, it's a goal line unit. Strong defense, can't stop runs up the middle with fair ease.
I do believe you're right. Here we are. We see, I do believe that's number 26. Oh, my goodness. We did not expect to see that. That was
Small bobble. The long snapper gave it a little bit too much power. 18-14, Rochelle will be set to kick.
And any extra points that Rochelle have been trying to get all night, none of them have been good. Two 2-point conversions down, nothing from them. And this extra point from the field goal was about to go up. First time we've seen it all night, did not work out in their favor.
Well, I'll be honest here. It seems like the offensive game is somewhat of a stalemate. The defensive game is pretty even as well. I think what's going to happen with the end of this game, it's going to come down to special teams. So that, the lack of persistence that we've seen from the Rochelle special teams may come back to bite them a little later. right now, Yorkville definitely dominating that sector.
Absolutely. Here we see deep downfield. That's number 27 and number 2 from Yorkville, respectively. That is Preston Brunohler and Dylan Wozotsky, Captain Dylan Wozotsky, mind you, back down deep.
Once again, Villalobos set the kick. He puts hang time on that ball, like, you know.
There you go.
I mean, it's impressive.
That ball taking a very Rochelle bounce.
And it'll fall into the end zone, so they'll call the touchback. So Yorkville will start off at the 20.
Well, for a game that has 6 minutes and 51 seconds remaining in it, and right now it's anybody's game still. If Yorkville can get it across the field, and if they can hold on to it, we can see Yorkville come away with a win. But Rochelle's defense has been spot on tonight also.
Well, I think what needs to happen is Yorkville needs to score quickly in case that defensive stop fails. And they'll try to run once again up the middle and a quick takedown and not catch who ran, looked like number 30. No, I'm sorry, that would be Delaney with the carry, number 33.
In my opinion, in the the current state of the game right now, when you got two evenly matched teams, both physically and mentally, you got to start whipping out what the other team isn't expecting in terms of plays. You got to start surprising them with things that you might not typically do in a normal game of football with a certain team.
And they'll line up with a different carry. So up the middle with somewhat of a play action fake. Draws about 2 yards, so we'll be about 3 and 4. All right, get a 4. So about 6 yards left, 3 and 4.
Brandon Lee on the carry. I'm not sure if I heard you say that, but you know, just giving credit there to Brandon Lee. Here we go. Setting up again, only 4 yards to go at least.
Yorkville set in the shotgun, same formation. Normally comes a pass out of this. They look like they're trying to go long, and the pass just slips out of the quarterback's hands.
Expect
there, Midas, not be happy about that one.
No, he's gonna be kicking himself about that, especially after the game. But you always gotta expect that Yorkville pass when you see him in that shotgun formation. Now, fourth down, I mean, they got 6 yards to go. What do you think we're going to see from here, Evan? Do you think they're going to try to run it still, or are they going to send out the punting team?
I think we are going to get a timeout here from Yorkville. The coach is still discussing what team they're going to send out on the field, so. And due to the confusion, Yorkville going to call a timeout.
Any timeout at the end of the game, as long as you have them, use them. You got to discuss what needs to be done here. Yorkville only down by 4 points. If they get a touchdown and they hold on to that, they hold on to that lead for the rest of the game, they'll be riding high. They won't have to worry about Rochelle, but Rochelle is a very tricky team. We've seen them match Yorkville, if not go a little bit further throughout the whole night. Rochelle is definitely one team to not sleep on.
Well, you definitely need all the timeouts you can get near the end of the game, but I think burning a timeout now might have been at least smarter than possibly messing up the play. And next thing you know, you got Rochelle in the red zone, up 2 touchdowns. And that's just something that I don't know that Yorkville would be able to bounce back from. So they're going to line up in punt formation, and they'll send it long. So a strong punt from the Foxes will roll out almost exactly at the 35.
A little Fox roll, ensuring the Hubs get a little bit further back in their own territory and have a longer way to go. First and 10 from the Hubs 35-yard line. I'd say still further deep in the Hubs territory than they are in the neutral zone.
Rochelle sending the normal running back. So they'll, I've noticed that they send out, they've got 85 Blake Albers when they're gonna run. So for most run play, all right, of course, you know, as soon as
of
I'm
course,
wrong.
Of course, yeah. As soon as they make a prediction, it's not right. But, hey, that's a first down for the Hubs. And there's Blake Albers on the reception, just talking about another Albers brother, as we can only assume.
So the two Albers seem to be the passing favorites. So Yorkville is going to set up. And their secondary has been struggling. But I don't know if it's so much that Yorkville's been struggling as Rochelle has just been having a great night in the air, especially the Albers brothers.
The luck they have in the air and the luck they have with the Albers brothers is just too good to not take advantage of. When it comes to a team that knows what they're doing, knows just their teammates well enough, they can read one another, and they got that on-field chemistry. That's exactly what they need to pull out the stops against Yorkville.
So, so Yorkville burning another timeout. They want to make sure that they get this four and out. I guess the coaching staff of Yorkville very confident in their clock management skills. Because being down four with two timeouts gone, this could end interestingly.
You might want to hope, at least, if it gets down to the crunch time and Yorkville does come away with the touchdown, but they burn out all of their timeouts, you can only hope that Rochelle were to call a timeout. And if it gets down to the point where Yorkville has no timeout left, there's going to be no way for the captain to communicate with the whole captains, coaches, pardon me, jeez. Coaches to communicate with the whole team. They have to make sure they use their timeouts effectively is the point of the story.
So now we see a confident Rochelle team step up to the line.
Rochelle
a little iffy, I'm sorry.
I'll go on ahead.
But Rochelle is ready for a, they're gonna make a quick run inside, but Yorkville was ready for them.
Yes. But we see right there, when they're looking down that line, Rochelle's seeing red, and that red is Yorkville, and they wanna get into Yorkville's end zone bad.
So Yorkville calling another timeout. They want at least 4 minutes on the clock.
You gotta wonder what is so important about Yorkville calling these three timeouts in this very short period of time. What do you think the coaches are trying to convey to them, Evan?
I think since they already had to burn the one timeout, they figured since they're down one, they're confident in their ability to score fast and get out of bounds, which we've seen on those side passes, where anytime you see Laramitis to really any of his wide receivers, but mainly Jason Luan, they love that side pass on the sideline to be able to get out of bounds. And I guess they're just very confident in their ability to continue with that if they need.
If they need to do it, they can definitely do that. Now, we see Rochelle coming back onto the field along with Yorkville, but Rochelle, no schlumps either. They got the Albers brothers, and they have, you know, one Albers brother is a running back, the other one's a wide receiver, and they both seem to be effective at doing their jobs.
So they're back for the pass. Long pass will come, and
oh my goodness, hard hits.
Get him in the hands, but you can't be too mad. I mean, he's, you know, beating himself up a little bit, but after getting hit that hard, no one is holding onto the ball after that one. So that, fortunately, Steven Eichner.
Zap Herbst bringing down Eichner with a big tackle. We see a fourth down now. Fourth and nine from the Foxes' 46-yard line. Foxes have a good enough time or have enough space to put an end to this if Rochelle doesn't feel like running it, by the way. Ball goes up and goes deep.
So they will leave it alone. And Rochelle will hold it there. So Yorkville, with only 4 minutes left, will be way back in their own zone.
You've got to wonder if what the coaches were telling the team were let the ball go that far deep and work your way up from there, run the clock down while you can. And while you're at the end zone, maybe it'll be to the point where it's about 30 seconds left on the clock, and you score that touchdown right there. You put the final nail in the coffin for Rochelle. But let's see if Rochelle allows that to happen. There's 4 minutes, and that's a lot of field to cover. But Rochelle can put an end to anything that Yorkville puts out.
Under the gun, they'll try to run it. Up the middle, stopped, but Delaney will at least grab about 4 or 5 yards. So the Yorkville Foxes are either going to look very smart or very foolish for burning all 3 timeouts and just letting the clock run by running it up the middle.
We can only hope that it was all part of the coach's plan to get all of their talking done and let the clock run out by using their timeouts.
Once again, Delaney not going down without a fight, but he will gain about a yard or so before he's stopped.
3.5 minutes remaining here in the entire game. 3rd and 1, 18 over 14. The Hubs are trumping the Foxes right now.
So 3rd and 1 as they line up once again under the gun in what seems to be the running formation. But they do have that wide receiver on the outside.
Always be on the lookout for that Yorkville pass. Hey, LaJuan taking that pass.
He's got space, but he can't quite get out of bounds. So the clock will continue to run as they gain another first down.
Lucky for them, I'll tell you though, the chemistry between Ty Laramidas and Jason LaJuan is from quarterback to wide receiver respectively. They both know where they need to be. They've only had a few slip-ups the entire night, but it's helpful. Ball handed off now to, I believe that's Delaney,
who will try to fight for the extra yard, getting up and over the defender. So he'll grab about 3 or 4 yards.
Clock running down to 2.5 minutes. It's getting kind of scary here for Yorkville.
So Yorkville set up in the gun.
This position always, what follows this position is always a pass, but we're going to have to see. You're going deep. LaJuan is, I can't tell if he caught that or not. Incomplete pass.
And he trapped it on the ground. I thought he just about had that, but unfortunately Yorkville player is a little in the way.
He got that out of bounds though. Clock is stopped. Give the Yorkville a little bit of time to recuperate. Talk it over in the huddle.
Well, you got 2 minutes and 14 seconds to go a long way down the field with no timeouts.
Yeah, as we see Yorkville coming out of that huddle, Rochelle was definitely not in the huddle. They're confident in their abilities to stop Yorkville. It's getting scary. Crunch time is definitely upon the Yorkville Foxes. They have to fight to maintain maybe even a scrap of a lead. Laramidas getting stressed out, getting punched down. By that was number 45. I see him coming away right away. That was Riley Williams.
And a hard sack, so clock ticks down under 2 minutes.
Disappointing from Yorkville. Yorkville just disappointed after that. Just,
you got to wonder that even though if this team is experienced, do they have that spike formation to be able to hold the clock? It does not seem that they do. They're letting it run, so about 1 minute 40 seconds left, 4th and 14. This is do or die for the Foxes.
We see Laramidas going back deep. Long pass. Is LaJuan available?
He hits it in. Ball down. Pass thrown a little short. And it looks like the Rochelle Hubs will, don't mean to call this early.
With 90 seconds left, it might be too early to call, but I do agree with you, Evan. They may come away with a victory here.
Well, Rochelle with no, or Yorkville with no timeouts. Rochelle is most likely going to set up in the victory formation.
You can only assume that whatever the coaches told Rochelle is going to stick with them, and there's no point in calling a timeout at this point. If Rochelle gets a touchdown here, it's going to be definitely embarrassing for the Foxes.
Oh, fumble!
Oh!
And the Hubs will fall on it, though. could have been a game changer.
That would have been definitely scary for the Hubs. Thankfully, Hubs didn't fumble it. That would have been embarrassing for them, too. Number of things that can go wrong that might embarrass the team, but as the clock ticks down, just around 1 minute, the Hubs are in victory formation.
Once again, they'll go for the knee.
Yep. Doing whatever they can to run time down.
So the clock will tick.
And what it appears, that is game. Well, let's just do a quick recap of the game while this is all winding down. Early on in the first quarter, the Hubs came out strong. They had that first early touchdown. Followed up, bringing in the second quarter, the Foxes followed suit and took the lead for a little bit, 1 point, 7-6.
And, well, you just saw the run game kind of dominate on both sides as both teams, you know, duked it out and shared points, scored touchdowns. But that the interception is really what put it away.
That interception.
Definitely came down to the pass defense from Rochelle.
It was definitely a great game. Both teams have nothing to be disappointed of. It was a great game. Maybe it was a little foolish of the Yorkville coaching staff taking all three timeouts, but I'm not one to speak. I'm not a coaching coordinator. But it was definitely all around a fantastic game, Evan.
And it was. Well, unfortunately, that for the Yorkville fans, they will take a non-conference loss. But it goes to show that there might be a little rebuilding. You see a lot of players make some fantastic plays. We look forward to the next game.
Yeah, absolutely. Yorkville, always looking forward to the next game. Yorkville's always a fantastic team to watch. So that's where it goes. Rochelle's team, Kevin Crandall, coming away with a 2-1 record now. Credits go out to our cameramen, Felix Fontanez and Eric Peterson. Our director tonight is Victor Mejia. Our producer, Mike Reynolds. Alongside me tonight is Evan Wiseman. And from Fox Valley TV, I'm Tom Molding.